Uhuru. Thank you, thank you. I want to thank all of you for coming out on today. There's a lot of stuff happening, and you have to be aware of it. You probably heard on the news today that Joan Bertrand Aristide is gone into exile and out of Haiti. It is something that was engineered by the United States government. They will not tolerate any place on earth an independent black country, an independent black state. And that is what Aristide attempted to bring to that situation. Poor, starving island, starving because of actions by first the French, who enslaved us in Haiti, and then the United States, who replaced the French after this incredible, the first workers' revolution in the history of the world happened in Haiti. Started in 1791, by 1804, the Africans there had defeated Napoleon's greatest army. Napoleon was the greatest general that Europe has ever known. And the Africans, people who just a few years earlier, a few weeks, days earlier, had been ragged servants to white people, rose up and brought Napoleon's army to its knees, forced the French to have to, after they defeated more than 20,000 crack French troops, the France which owned, having stolen first, part of this territory that's known as Louisiana. France was forced to sell Louisiana to the American government because it couldn't maintain itself after Napoleon's troops had been defeated by Africans in Haiti. It's an incredible revolutionary process, but for the more than 50 years after Haiti was liberated, the United States government even refused to recognize its existence. They got together with the French and forced Haiti, as a condition of being recognized, to pay reparations to the white people from France. They had to pay the white people for their property that was destroyed, and of course part of the property was the Africans ourselves. They had to pay the white people for the war. They had to pay the white people more than 130 million francs, French francs. And this is the thing that started Haiti off as a debtor country. And Haiti has been in debt since that time. And there's a lot more nasty stuff that white power has done to African people in Haiti. But you should know about that. And you should know that America has no innocence there. This standing around wondering whether we should go in. America has never not been in Haiti. America has been in Haiti since the Haitian Revolution won our freedom in the first place. So you should be aware of that. And you should really be concerned about what is happening there. And I'm open at some juncture in this discussion. If you want to talk more about that, we can talk about it because it's important to you.
It's time for me more than a riot. The warriors can't keep quiet. It's time for me more than a riot.
Those who came before us.
Quiet. It's time for me more than a riot.
Long live the revolution.
Can't keep quiet. It's time for me more than a riot.
Religion is like prison. Keep the people locked up in different divisions. Some of them promise you heaven, but I see a whole lot of bullshit, ism, schism. Imperialism in the form of spirituality. Slave mentality, escape reality. What we supposed to just suffer and smile and be content, sending our prayers to the clouds. I want my heaven now, freedom on earth. And if the preach ain't with us, then we take it as church. What is it worth to have the biggest religion when the people got miserable living conditions? No water, no lights, no rights. All over Africa we fight, but we have to unite. Cause ain't no power in the gospel when the priest putting powder in his nostril, and the elders' council fails to lead, and the children suffer from daily need, and the people can barely eat. Is it a sin to stand up and fight against the ones that put us in handcuffs? God damn, what happened to the daily
bread? Yeah. They pray I die, I'm that nigga that they love to hate.
Yeah.
I wanna make you use your mind, God is the sign.
Yeah.
And when you listen to these rhymes, nigga, take your time.
Yeah.
Again, I ask, heaven was hell and vice versa.
Yeah.
First you start doing evil in order to nurture.
Yeah.
The spirit, man, do you understand that there's a war?
Yeah.
It's raging on, and the devil got some ammo too.
Yeah.
Don't get me wrong, but I put my trust out.
and to deal with all this wickedness. I focus on it. Lou, I'm grown, but I'm still a baby. It's vice versa, so I guess I've been saving the saving. God, I'm confused. Refuse the father.
It's time to be born in a riot. To the warriors, can't keep quiet. It's time to be born in a riot.
Those who came before us,
riot. It's time to be born in a riot.
Long live the revolution.
Can't keep quiet. This time will be more than a riot.
Religion is like prison. Keep the people locked up in different divisions. Some of them promise you heaven, but I see a whole lot of bullshit, ism, schism. Imperialism in the form of spirituality. Slave mentality, escape reality. Were we supposed to just suffer and smile and be content? Sending our prayers to the clouds. I want my heaven now, freedom on earth. And if the preacher ain't with us, then we take it as church. What is it worth to have the big